Guys, in this video we will be discussing about the burning issues in the world, that is coronavirus disease 2019. The seminar was presented by Department of Medicine, TMSS Medical College. A very special thanks for providing us this information. The coronaviruses are the group of viruses that cause disease mainly in mammals and birds. These viruses are in the family coronaviridae. These are envelope virus with positive single-stranded RNA. The name of the virus is given according to its crown-like structure. On 11 February, World Health Organization named this outbreak as COVID-19. The novel coronavirus is affecting more than 151 countries around the world. As the latest data of March 17, 2020, near about 2,11,670 coronavirus cases are detected. Among them, 84,880 cases were recovered, and the serious cases are 5,967. The death is 8,064, which is 3.80%, and the mild condition is 84,656. These viruses are mainly transmitted through the respiratory droplets that are generated by sneezing and coughing. There are 7 strains of human coronaviruses, as you can see here in the figure. And the new one is novel coronavirus 2019. The symptoms, according to WHO, signs of infection include fever, cough, shortness of breath, and breathing difficulties. There may not be fever, or the patient may suffer from the nausea, diarrhea, malaise, and lethargy. And in more severe cases, it can lead to pneumonia, severe acute respiratory syndrome, SARS, kidney failure, and even to death. The incubation period of the coronavirus is unknown. Some sources it could be between 10 to 14 days. Here, the clinical management of severe acute respiratory infection when novel coronavirus infection is suspected. Here, the first is triage. Recognize and sort patients with SARI, severe acute respiratory infection. The second, immediate implementation of appropriate infection prevention and control measures. Early supportive therapy and monitoring, collection of specimens for laboratory diagnosis, management of hypoxic respiratory failure and acute respiratory distress syndrome, management of septic shock, prevention of complications, septic anti-NCOV treatment, that is novel coronavirus, special considerations for pregnant patients. Triage, early recognition of patients with severe acute respiratory infection associated with 2019 novel coronavirus infection. Here, recognize and sort all patients with SARI at first point of contact with healthcare system as the emergency department. Consider novel coronavirus 19 as a possible etiology of SARI under certain conditions. Triage patient and start emergency treatment based on disease severity. Novel coronavirus 19 infection may present with mild, moderate, or severe illness. The latter includes severe pneumonia, ARDS, sepsis, and septic shock. Early recognition of suspected patients allows for timely initiation of IPC. Early identification of those with severe manifestations allows for immediate optimized supportive care treatments and safe rapid admission to intensive care unit according to institutional or national protocols. Here, the definition of patients with severe acute respiratory infection. It is an acute respiratory infection with history of fever or major temperature more than equals to 38 degrees Celsius and cough. Onset within the last 10 days and requiring hospitalization. However, the absence of fever does not exclude viral infection. Here you can see the case definition for novel coronavirus 19. clinical syndromes associated with 2019 novel coronavirus infection: uncomplicated illness, mild pneumonia, severe pneumonia, acute respiratory distress syndrome, sepsis, septic shock. So the laboratory diagnosis: real-time reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction, RT-PCR, and RNA extraction. WHO guidance on collection of specimens for laboratory diagnosis: collection of blood cultures for bacteria that cause pneumonia and sepsis, ideally before antimicrobial therapy. Do not delay antimicrobial therapy to collect blood cultures. Collect specimens from both the upper respiratory tract, that is nasopharynx and oropharynx, and lower respiratory tract. Clinicians may elect to collect only LRT samples when these are readily available, for example in mechanically ventilated patients. Serology for diagnostic purposes is recommended only when RT-PCR is not available. In hospitalized patients with confirmed novel coronavirus 19 infection, repeat URT and LRT, that is upper and lower respiratory tract samples, should be collected to demonstrate viral clearance. Immediate implementation of appropriate measures: advise apply droplet precautions, contact precautions, and airborne precautions when performing an aerosol generating procedure. Advise: give suspect patient a medical mask and direct patient to separate area. An isolation room is if available, keep at least 1 meter distance between suspected patient and other patient. Instruct all patients to cover nose and mouth during coughing or sneezing with tissue or flexed elbow for others. Perform hand hygiene after contact with respiratory secretions. Droplet precautions: droplet precautions prevent large drop transmission of respiratory viruses. Use a medical mask if walking within 1 to 2 meters of patient. Place patients in single room or group together, those with the same etiological diagnosis. When providing care is close contact with a patient with respiratory symptoms such as coughing or sneezing, use eye protection, face mask, because sprays of secretions may occur. Limit patient movement within the institution and ensure that patients wear medical masks when outside their rooms. Contact precautions: here you can see the different contact precautions by using personal protective equipment such as medical masks, eye protection, gloves, gowns. If possible, use either disposable or dedicated equipment such as stethoscopes, blood pressure cuffs, and thermometers. If equipment needs to be shared among patients, clean and disinfect between each patient use. Personal protective equipment: here are, you can see the different equipment in this figure. Ensure that healthcare workers remain from touching their eyes, nose, and mouth with potentially contaminated gloves or ungloved hands. Avoid contaminating environmental surfaces that are not directly related to patient care, such as door handles and light switches. And also ensure adequate room ventilation. Avoid movements of patients or transport, perfume, and perform hand hygiene. Airborne precaution when performing an aerosol generating procedure: ensure that healthcare workers performing aerosol generating procedure, that is open suction of respiratory tract, intubation, bronchoscopy, cardiopulmonary resuscitation, use personal protective equipment including gloves, long sleeves, gowns, eye protection, and fitted particulate respirators. Early supportive therapy and monitoring, in which give supplemental oxygen therapy immediately to patient with SARI and respiratory distress, hypoxemia, or shock. Use conservative fluid management in patients with SARI when there is no evidence of shock. Keep empirical antimicrobial therapy to treat all likely pathogens causing SARI. keep antimicrobial within 1 hour of initial patient assessment for patients with sepsis. Do not routinely give systemic corticoids for treatment of viral pneumonia or acute respiratory distress syndrome outside of clinical trials unless they are indicated for another reason. Closely monitor patients with SARI for signs of clinical deterioration such as rapidly progressive respiratory failure and sepsis and apply supportive care interventions immediately. Understand the patient's comorbid conditions to tailor the management of critical illness and appreciate the prognosis. Communicate early with patient and family. Management of hypoxemia, respiratory failure and ARDS. Recognize severe hypoxemic respiratory failure when a patient with respiratory distress is following standard oxygen therapy, high flow nasal oxygen, or non-invasive ventilation should only be used in selected patients with hypoxemic respiratory failure. Endotracheal intubation should be performed by a trained and experienced provider using airborne precautions. In patients with severe ARDS, prone ventilation for more than 12 hours per day is recommended. Use a conservative fluid management strategy for ARDS patients without tissue hyperperfusion. Avoid disconnecting the patient from the ventilators, use inline catheters for airway suctioning and clamp endotracheal tube when disconnection is required. Example, transfer to transport ventilator. Management of septic shock. Recognize septic shock in adults when infection is suspected or confirmed. Recognize septic shock in children with any hypotension. Here you can see the altered mental state, tachycardia or bradycardia, prolonged capillary refill, tachypnea, motile skin or petechial or purpuric rash, increased lactate, oliguria, hyper or hypothermia. Resuscitation from septic shock. In adults, keep at least 30 ml per kg of isotonic crystalloid in adults in the first 3 hours. In children, in well-resourced settings, keep 20 ml per kg as a rapid bolus and up to 40 to 60 ml per kg in the first hour. Do not use hypnotic crystalloids, esters, or gelatins for resuscitation. Fluid resuscitation may lead to volume overload, including respiratory failure. If there is no response to fluid loading and sign of volume overload appear, for example, jugular venous distension, crackles on lung auscultation, pulmonary edema on imaging, or hepatomegaly in children, then reduce or discontinue fluid administration. This step is particularly important where mechanical ventilation is not available. Alternate fluid regimens are suggested when caring for children in resource-limited settings. Prevention of complication. Reduce days of invasive mechanical ventilation. Use weaning protocols that include daily assessment for readiness to breathe spontaneously. Minimize continuous or intermittent sedation, targeting specific titration endpoints or with daily interruption of continuous sedative infusions. Reduce incidence of ventilators-associated pneumonia. Here are the points. Reduce incidence of venous thromboembolism. Reduce incidence of catheter-related bloodstream infection. Reduce incidence of stress, ulcers, and gastrointestinal bleeding. Reduce incidence of ICU-related weakness. Specific anti-novel coronavirus treatments and clinical research. There is no current evidence to recommend any specific anti-novel coronavirus treatment for patients with suspected or confirmed novel coronavirus 19 infection. unlicensed treatments should be administered only in the context of ethically approved clinical trials or the monitored emergency use of unregistered interventional framework with strict monitoring. Special considerations for pregnant patients. Pregnant women with suspected or confirmed novel coronavirus 19 infection should be treated with supportive therapies as described above, taking into account the physiologic adaptation of pregnancy. The use of investigational therapeutic agents outside of a research study should be guided by individual risk-benefit analysis based on potential benefit for mother and safety to fetus, with consultation from an obstetric specialist and ethics committee. Emergency delivery and pregnancy termination decisions are challenging and based on many factors: gestational age, maternal condition, and fetal stability. Consultants with obstetric, neonatal, and intensive care specialists are essential. Here, different questions arising for novel coronavirus 19. Can pets at home spread the new coronavirus? At present, there is no evidence that companion animals, pets such as dogs or cats, can be infected with the novel coronavirus. However, it is always a good idea to wash your hands with soap and water after contact with pets. This protects you against various common bacteria such as Escherichia coli and Salmonella that can pass between pets and humans. Do vaccines against pneumonia protect you against the new coronavirus? No, vaccine against pneumonia does not protect. Can regularly rinsing your nose with saline help prevent infection with the new coronavirus? No, there is no such evidence. Can gargling mouthwash protect you from infection with the new coronavirus? No. Can eating garlic help prevent infection with the new coronavirus? There is no evidence. Garlic is a healthy food that may have some antimicrobial properties. However, there is no evidence from the current outbreak that eating garlic has protected people from the novel coronavirus infection. Does putting on sesame oil block the new coronavirus from entering the body? That is no. Does the new coronavirus affect older people, or are younger people also susceptible? People of all ages can be infected by the novel coronavirus 19. Older people and people with pre-existing medical conditions such as bronchial asthma, diabetes mellitus, heart disease appear to be more vulnerable to becoming severely ill with the virus. World Health Organization advises people of all ages to take steps to protect themselves from the virus, for example by following good hand hygiene and good respiratory hygiene. Are antibiotics effective in preventing and treating the new coronavirus? No, antibiotic does not work against viruses. They work only against bacteria. Are there any specific medicines to prevent or treat the new coronavirus? To date, there is no specific medicine recommended to prevent or treat the new coronavirus. The myths about the novel coronavirus 19. The myth 1. You can catch the novel coronavirus if you eat Chinese food. Myth 2. Eating ice creams and frozen food items can spread the novel coronavirus. Myth number 3, applying cow dung and consuming cow urine can cure novel coronavirus 19. These are only the myths. Myth 4, you can catch coronavirus if you receive a package from China. A cure for novel coronavirus has been found. Bat soups and snakes are responsible for new coronavirus outbreak. These are only the myths. Take home message for public. Wash your hand. Wash your hand with soap and running water when hands are visibly dirty. If your hands are not visibly dirty, frequently clean them by using alcohol-based hand rub or soap and water. Better to use your soap and water than sanitizers. protect yourself and others from getting sick. Washing your hands after coughing or sneezing while caring for the sick, before, during, and after you prepare food, before eating, after toilet, when hands are visibly dirty, after handling animals or animal waste. Protect others from getting sick. When coughing and sneezing, cover mouth and nose with flexed elbow or tissue. Throw tissue into close bin immediately after use. Clean hands with alcohol-based hand rub or soap and water after coughing or sneezing and when caring for the sick. Avoid close contact when you are experiencing cough and fever. Avoid spitting in public. If you have fever, cough, and difficulty breathing, seek medical care early and share previous travel history with your healthcare provider. Use different chopping boards and knives for raw meat and cooked food. Wash your hands between handling raw and cooked food. Seek animals and animals that have died of disease should not be eaten. Even in areas experiencing outbreaks, meat products can be safely consumed if these items are cooked thoroughly and properly handled during food preparation. Shopping in wet markets in China and South Asia. Wash hands with soap and water after touching animals and animal products. Avoid touching eyes, nose, and mouth. Avoid contact with sick animals and spoiled meat. Avoid contact with stray animals, waste, and fruits in the market. Wear protective gowns, gloves, and facial protection while handling animals and animals' products. Remove protective clothing after work. Wash daily and leave at the work site. Avoid exposing family members to soiled work clothing and shoes. Frequently wash your hands with soap and water after touching animals and animal products. Disinfect equipment and working area at least once a day. Stay healthy while traveling. Avoid travel if you have a fever and cough. If you have a fever, cough, and difficulty breathing, seek medical care early and share previous travel history with your healthcare provider. Avoid close contact with people suffering from a fever and cough. Frequently wash your hands by using alcohol-based hand rub or soap and water. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, mouth. When coughing and sneezing, cover mouth and nose with flexible elbow tissue. Throw tissue away immediately and wash hands. If you choose to wear a mask, be sure to cover the mask, mouth, and nose, avoiding touching mask once it's on. Immediately discard single-use masks after its use and wash hands after removing masks. If you become sick while traveling, inform crew and seek medical care. If you seek medical attention, share travel history with your healthcare provider. Eat only well-cooked food. Avoid spitting in public. Avoid close contact and travel with animals that are sick. Respect for the real fighters, the UN doctors. In case of suspected patient, it is for the Bangladesh. The patient should stay at home. Admit the severe ill patient to hospital. The number here is given for the Bangladeshi. And record patient's name, age, contact address, contact number, and send the data to IEDCR control room 01700705537 or hotline number 01937110011 01927711711 or 01927711784 01927711785. Please do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe our channel, Medical Review. Thank you.